Hello, everyone. Good evening. It's me again, Derek Mendoza. I live on 4th Street. I'm a direct abutter. I've been in East Providence for my entire life, in the exact same house for my entire life. I spent a lot of time looking for a new house when it came time for me to move out, and it took a year, and I just couldn't find something that I really enjoyed more than East Providence, and especially more than that local area. So I have, obviously, I guess I would be Partesian, kind of, but not as an expert witness, but just as a person here speaking on behalf of the community. I've given you a lot of research and a lot of my time on like analysis and numbers that I've quoted, and you know, I do that as an officer of a local Fortune 500 company with a background in technology, analytics, and research. And I would happily provide more information to you or anyone here in this audience about anything that I've quoted before. I don't want to rehash all of that. I'd rather talk about, over the past year, I've been approached by a lot of people in the community. Friends, high school, because I've been here my whole life. And even people I don't know, neighbors I never even met, they came up to me and, you know, I wasn't going to speak tonight, but they asked me, like, keep doing what you're doing, keep talking, because a lot of them just don't feel brave enough to come up here and talk, and they're not maybe well-formed about how to speak, and they want me to come up here and just continue to support on their behalf. And so I wanted to focus my 3 minutes just quickly on that. And a lot of them say the same thing. You know, when this plan was first proposed way back a year and a half ago, a lot of them were just scared and, you know, even nauseous, and seeing something that's been in our community for so long get changed, it's really difficult. And Personally, you know, I do want to give kudos to Marshall and the development for coming a long way from that original plan, because that original plan was frankly a nightmare to me and a lot of the community, and this is a vast improvement. But the fact is that everyone that I've talked to has had kind of the same idea, same feeling, that they just don't want to see anything there, that it's been that space for so long, and they'd like to keep it that way. Now, of course, you have a very difficult decision in front of you where you, by right, they can develop a certain way, or you could potentially control what they develop with this approval. I still feel as though eminent domain is worth entertaining. And yes. I think that one thing that I want to say that's a little bit different that made me think when I was preparing for this is I come up to you and I talk about all the people I've talked to, and I realize that to you it's hearsay. Like, I can make that up. I don't have a signed petition or anything like that. And even the petition itself has been questioned and called about, like, are the numbers, the 5,000 signatures, legitimate? Is there really that much support? Numbers in the Facebook group? I think one thing that hasn't really been discussed is whether it's worth bringing this to a special election for the people to decide themselves. And if the numbers are there, then, you know, that will really speak to the legitimacy of what KMG claims, what the community claims, as far as how many people support and really want to see it remain green. Thank you.